hemodialysis tubing sets, or also known as the blood lines, and the 1 liter of NSS. First, do hand hygiene before doing any procedure or handling any patient. Next, put on your clean gloves. Both hand hygiene and clean glove use are strategies to prevent transmission of infections through hand contact. In the context of patient care, it makes sense to think of glove use and hand hygiene as complementary strategies to prevent transmission of pathogens or germs. The hemodialysis tubing set contains the arterial bloodlines, the venous bloodlines with drainage bag, the IV set for the NSS, and the transducer and connector. The patient's pre-HD weight. The UF goal is determined by the difference between the patient's weight from previous HD treatment and current pre-HD weight. Next, assist the patient to the designated HD treatment area. Then, assist him or her to put on the patient's gown. Then, pre-HD vital signs should be taken. The patient's blood pressure, the patient's body temperature, the patient's pulse rate, respiration rate, and the O2 saturation. In other HD institutions. First, take the arterial bloodline. Hang the arterial dialyzer port to a dialyzer holder. Then put the arterial chamber in place. Open the blood pump and place or thread the blood pump segment to the blood pump. Transducer and attach it to the arterial transducer port. Then connect it to the arterial pressure sensor and make sure that it is secured well. Then get the venous lines. Place the drainage bag on the IV pole. dialyzer port to a dialyzer holder. Make sure that the arterial chamber line is placed on the venous chamber. Put the venous chamber loosely in place without locking it on the air detector. Make sure that the arterial chamber line is placed behind the venous chamber. Then, put the venous transducer port in a venous pressure sensor. Make sure that it is secured well. Then, connect the venous end to the arterial end together. Then, temporarily set aside. Then, get the NSS. Open it and place it on the IV pole. Then get the IV set and make sure to close the roller clamp. Attach the port of the IV set to the arterial NSS line. Spike the NSS. Fill the chamber about 3/4. Then open the roller clamp. Clamp the arterial NSS line and feel the venous line and the venous chamber by gravity. Hold the venous clamp and wait for the NSS to feel the venous dialyzer port. Then, clamp it. The arterial chamber. Then, manually turn the blood pump until the arterial chamber is 3/4 full. Chamber is 3/4 full, place the arterial chamber upright. Then, continue to manually turn the blood pump until the dialyzer port is filled with NSS.